and the relations, as you can see here in the example. And each of them, so the components as well as the relations, they have types, specific types. So here we have, for example, a PHP application. We have a connect to relation. Here we have some post on relations. So we can describe the structure of the application. Furthermore, we have some properties we can add. So for example, here in the relation, we have sensitive data, which I exchanged here. And for example, the OpenStack, they require a username, a password, and they are in a specific location here. So what does restructuring mean? Restructuring means that we have to redistribute our components of the application to different target locations, and so we also have to adapt the topology accordingly. And this can be done by assigning target labels to the components. We introduced this approach last year at the Closer conference. And so therefore, with these labels, we can indicate how we want to distribute the components. And here I just want to show you how it looks, can look like. So here we want to move one of the application to Amazon. So we have to adapt the topology. So we have to add two new components so that it's hosted now on an EC2 instance. So this just to make sure that you know what I'm talking about when we talk about restructured deployment models. So now we changed the topology. And what are the consequences now? Okay, so the components which formerly were hosted on the same host are now distributed, so they are in different environments. This also means that the communication now, which were formerly taking place on the same environment, is now taking place over the internet, over a public network, and so the sensitive data are exchanged across the public network. This is what we can see here in this example, which is small example, but there can several other things happen. So for example, there could be a firewall which restricted in one environment. We can have different communication infrastructures and so on. So there can be several other issues. So the question is, so we adapted the topology, and the question is, do we have any problems now? We don't know. So is it still a valid topology which you can deploy, and the behavior is the same and everything as we want to have it? So this is what we want to achieve for our approach. We want to enable the problem detection in such restructured deployment models, and we want to automate this detection to support the human operators. So first of all, how we apply the knowledge. I think most of you already know the concept of patterns, which were introduced in towns and buildings. So what patterns do they describe? Recurring problems and best practice solutions for such problems. And in the software engineers and architects, they took this concept of patterns to also describe such recurring problems and their solutions for the domain of designing software and architectures. So here made some of you know the Game of Four or the enterprise integration patterns, the cloud computing patterns, security patterns. So there's a huge number, a huge amount of different patterns already there. So what they do is describing already knowledge of how to design a system. And I want to give you a short example, which is a running example for the rest of the presentation. So one example here is the secure channel pattern, which is part of the security patterns. And all patterns describe a problem, so it's a textual description. And the problem is how we ensure that data being passed across public or semi-public space is secure in transit. So that's a problem. Then we have a context description, which give us more information in which context this problem can occur. So here, okay, there's a system delivering some functionalities, some clients use the functionality, they exchange data over a public network, and these data are sensitive. And then they give a solution which is independent of a specific technology, so it's a more generic description. So, okay, the solution is create a secure channel for the sensitive data to enable an encrypted communication between the components. So we have this kind of descriptions. There are several other sections for describing patterns, but this is what is the most interesting part for our approach now. And so we have these different patterns. We have our topology, we restructured the topology. We have all this knowledge in mind, we apply this knowledge, we have reread all these books, we know what can occur, and then we can detect the problem. And here we detect the problem, okay. Hey, these two stacks are in different locations. We have some sensitive data, but we can't find some security mechanisms. So we think we have a problem. Okay, as I said, a lot of different patterns for different domains, so we have to know all of them. So our idea was, okay, we want to automate it, we want to enable detecting the problems automatically. So this is why we introduced the automated problem detection by formalized patterns. And our approach for the pattern formalization based on logic programming, and I just want to shortly introduce it. So logic programming can be used to express the domain knowledge in facts and rules. So the facts describe the circumstances, the relations between objects, with the predicate and the arguments, and we have some rules which have some conditions describing dependencies between facts so that we can check whether a rule is satisfied or not. And in our approach, we use the logic programming language PROLOG. So I just want to give a short example that you well know what we did. So on the left side, you can see an example of facts. On the right side, it's a rule. So what you can see here, that's in variables. So we know, okay, Ben is the father of John, and Ben is male, and John is also male. So this is our fact, there can be several more. And then we have a rule here that says, okay, X is the son of Y, so which are both variables, if Y is the father of X, and Y is male, and X is male. So that's a simple rule, and with this rule we can query our fact base. So we can, for example, ask, is John the son of Ben? And the answer would be yes. Or we can also ask, do there objects exist, some facts in our fact base, some invariables for which this rule is fulfilled, satisfied? And in this example, yes, there are some facts, so yeah, invariables. So for X, John, and for Y, Ben. So we know John is the son of Ben. So this just shortly. So we come back to the approach, okay, we want to apply the patterns to the restructured deployment models. So on the one side we have the patterns, on the other side we have the topology. And at the beginning I talked about what are the components of the topology. So we have an underlying meta model which describes the syntax of a topology. We have components, we have relations, we have the types of components and relations. We have assigned properties and target labels, which is an extension which is not relevant here in this part. So we have the syntax, and we can use this to transform our topology to PROLOG facts, and on the other side, formalize our textual descriptions. And as I indicated here, this transformation can easily be done automated because we have the syntax, we have our topology, and we can just write it down as facts. The other side is more complicated. So here, of course, a human process to read the textual description to take out the essential information and to describe the rules. So we have here now the rule to check if you have an insecure public communication between two components, here the variables C1 and C2, with some conditions, and here we have the facts, and I just want to show how we detect now the problem in our fact data to see an example how it works. So the first condition is that there is a variable property sensitive data which have to be true, and we check to the facts, yes, we have such a variable in our facts, the HTTP connection, which is this one. This HTTP connection must be of type connects to. Yeah, because there should be an exchange of data. Okay, you can also find this here. We have a relation between two components. Okay, this relation connects two components, and these two components are in different locations. this one is again a rule, which I did not explain here on the slides to make it easier, but I just look at all on the stacks to find out if we have a location property in our stacks to see if the components, the hosting stacks, if there is a location indicated, so that I can see if they're in different locations and we don't have any security mechanisms. So in this case, we can detect there is a problem, that we have an insecure communication between the two components, and which pattern can help us to solve it. As I already mentioned, yes, it's easier to automate the transformation from topology to facts. We implemented a prototype, which you can find on GitHub. It's based on Tosca, and we use the modeling tool Binary to model the Tosca topologies, and use SWI Prolog to run the check the queries for the rules, and you can add such markdown files to the system to describe the patterns and to also give the problem rule here, and then the tool takes all of these descriptions and checks all available described patterns against the topology described as facts. And okay, we have this prototype, we applied it already to different patterns, and of course I think most of you also ask, okay, we have the syntax available to describe a topology, but what is missing is the semantic bit, because it's hard otherwise to make sure that the formalized patterns fits to the topology. So this is what is one of the most important future work, to define such a semantic model for the topologies and the rules. And also, of course, we don't only want to detect problems, we also want to apply the solution we detected. So this is another point which is important in the future. So thank you very much for your attention. I hope we have some further discussions at the poster session later.
We have time for one question, please. Nobody questions, so I have a question. So you produce prologue programs.
Mm-hmm.
And there's always a danger that they are too large, inefficient to run. So have you a problem with this aspect?
So because we are on the design time, on the modeling time, it's not that it's an ongoing check during runtime and the dynamic redistribution in runtime, so we are just looking on the modeling time. So in this case, I think performance is not this important as when we are looking at the migration dynamic.
Wonderful. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
The next speaker is Johannes Manner, and he will speak about troubleshooting serverless functions. Please.